Hi everyone, it's Kevin, welcome back to the channel. Today it's resin test. I have three different resin from Resion. They contact me and asked me if I wanted to try some of them, so I was like, for sure. I have two elastic slash flexible resin and one eye detail, so I'm just gonna print some stuff, do some testing and see what kind of result I get. Let's go. Okay, so first let's start with the F69. So that's a black resin and it's a bit more like a rubber, so it's pretty hard, it's flexible but it's a bit tougher and more resistant than other kind of print, so that's good. In terms of utility, I think it's nice. Let's do some testing and let's see what kind of behavior the resin have. Okay, so here I printed a ring with some hole in the middle. And when I'm trying to flex the resin, it's quite like tough. There's still a good flex and then everything go back to shape after a while. So that's pretty good. The strength is really nice as well. I went slowly and then I realized, okay, I'm gonna have to go harder on it. So I really pushed and then I finally was able to break it. But as you can see, it took me quite some time. It's quite solid, so that's really good for flexible resin. You can see a spring that is full flex and everything is coming back slowly. And here it's more like a wheel, small wheel, so there is some hole behind but it's still quite solid, so the flex is minimal. Okay, so let's talk about some of the specific. First, the price. It's $85 right now on the website. I think it's okay. It's still pricey. Any kind of flexible resin, you're gonna have to pay premium for it. So it's a bit annoying, but it's like it's okay for the range of price, I think, for 1 liter. The odor, it's good as well. When I mean good, it's still like resin. You're gonna smell a bit, but it doesn't have a strong odor at all. And that's good because I've tried some other flexible resin like the Monocure 3D and this one was really smelly, so that's a good point on this one. The resin is quite thick, so when you clean up your print, make sure you go really like a lot on it. You make sure you clean every kind of hole because the resin is gonna stick inside every kind of gap that you have, so you really have to shake it in the IPA, use a toothbrush, make sure you brush on top, because if you want to really clean properly your print, you're gonna have to just use a lot of IPA and brush over and stuff. And then for the support as well, small detail, if you support your print, everything is gonna flex in the vat on the beer plate, so make sure you add a bit more support than you would do usually. I had a couple of prints where it was a bit shaky, you had to add more, which makes sense, it's kind of normal. The detail are retained pretty well, I think, as well. I've done the Emerald Lab testing print and nothing was super sharp and super detailed, but it was pretty decent for a rubber type of resin. I think it's pretty good. On the exposure, you can go on the website. They have a chart with your printer, the type of resin. You just follow everything. I'm on the Anycubic Photon S and I have an Elegoo Mars screen at the moment. So I was at 60 second exposure, 12 second normal layer. And the leaf speed was a bit lower as well. You just look on the chart, everything will be here. So it was pretty good and everything went pretty well. So that's about it for this one. It's a pretty good resin. And yeah, I recommend if you want a rubber type resin. Okay, so right now let's try the F80. So this one is a really flexible, really easy to move around the elastic resin. That's what they call it. So let's do some testing and see how it behaves a little bit. Okay, so here I have the same ring as before, and as you can see, I barely push on it and everything flexed all the way. The shape came back really quick as well, so it's really nice. It's really like malleable and flexible and everything came back to shape really easily. The downside is the strength is less than the rubber one, so here if I start pushing a little bit, then the ring is gonna break. But that's okay, it's part of the deal. If you have to choose between strength and flexibility. Here, same on the spring, everything came back really quick into shape. So it's pretty interesting, pretty good resin. Okay, so let's talk about some of the specific now. On the website, I saw the price at $57 for 500 grams. So apparently they don't sell 1 liter, but you just multiply by 2 if you want 1 liter. And I think it's getting a bit pricey, and you have to really consider before you buy those kind of resin, I think. For the odor, this one was a bit similar to the other one, pretty low. You can still smell a bit, but it's not really high in terms of odor. So that's really good. I like it. And in terms of like the texture, this one is really, really gooey. Like it's super thick, kind of like chewing gum. It's going really slow on the vat and stuff. So when you clean your print again, you really have to spend some time and make sure you go around. If you have small hole, small gap where the resin is, it's there, you really have to clean in between, because the resin is not going to be shake off really easily. Same if you clean your vat, it's not really fun to do, so you have to think about it. And for the detail, the Emerald Lab testing was pretty good as well, pretty decent for flexible resin again, so kind of surprising, that's nice. And for the chart on the website, I was at 50 bottom exposure and 10 normal exposure, which is pretty good. And the speed lifting was a bit low, but that's good as well, because you just want to be slow and be careful, because this one is moving so quick and so fast. So you want everything to be slow. You want to add a lot of support, make sure everything is stable and not just gonna move around in your vat. And I think that's a pretty good resin as well. If you're looking for something like really flimsy, really easy to flex quickly, that's pretty nice. Okay, so now let's jump to the M70. So this one is more like normal resin. It's hard. It's made to retain detail mostly. So let's see what kind of result I've got on some miniatures. Okay, so I've picked up a bunch of random miniatures online, pre-supported already, just to test the resin. And here I'm pretty impressed. This one, it came out really, really nicely. Here you can see the belt buckle a little bit. Everything is super sharp, all the details. On the sword, on the handle, there is some tiny hole there here. So everything is nice. Here, obviously, if you push on it, like the small arrow, everything's gonna break. But it's more like classic resin. You have a tiny bit of flex for it, but it's hard, and if you push on it, it's gonna break, it's gonna snap. Trying on the leg now. Still a good resistance. This one, the mummy is pretty cool as well. All the bandages are really sharp on the edge, so that's really nice. There is still some support mark. I didn't clean up anything. I took off the supports, clean into the IPA, and that's it. This one, the face have a lot of detail, but really, really tiny, and they are all here. On the back of the calf here, the armor have some texture, and the texture is there as well, so pretty, pretty good stuff here. Here the Emerald Lab tests. Every details are on the print. All the tiny window, the tiny dots, the number written on top at the back here. So really nothing to say. Okay, so into some of the specific now. The resin is at $50 for 1 liter. That's pretty good. It's a bit more expensive than like classic resin, the normal like Illigo Grey or Anycubic and stuff like this. So you pay a little bit more, but you get way more detail, in my opinion. I think it's worth it. If what you're looking for is for a lot of detail, I think it's good. Like I said, I'm printing on the Anycubic Photon S. That's an old printer. The screen is the Illigo Mars screen, and it's like normal print, normal screen. It's not really good resolution, so usually I get really good print, I mean decent for what I'm doing, and I know that's kind of like my top in terms of like the printer and the quality. And I didn't know I could really like step up the quality with just having a good detail resin, so I was really impressed and really surprised with the result. Usually people, they are like, oh, I need a new printer to have a better quality on my miniature. Even if you have an old printer or even a good one right now, you can probably step up your miniature and your detail with those kind of resins. So I would really recommend this one. Now for the exposure, this one was 70 seconds on the bottom exposure and 8 seconds on the normal layer. I think the normal layer is kind of classic. Usually I go around 7, 7.5, so I just bumped a little bit compared to usual. But the bottom exposure was way more than normal. I think because the resin doesn't expand too much, it's hard for the resin to expand this one to retain all the details. So that's why your bottom exposure needs to be really long in order to make sure everything's going to stick to the beer plate. I looked on the website, apparently there is like a new version of this resin with a better like adhesion on the bottom layer. So I'm not sure which one I've got, but they are trying to improve this, so that's pretty good. And yeah, so my conclusion on this one, try it. If you're looking for really good detail, I really recommend this one. If you want to make good miniature and you're ready to just spend a bit more on the resin, that's definitely worth it. I hope this video is gonna help you and answer some of your questions if you have on some resin. And if you want some information, just tell me in the comment. See you next time.